Good morning, everyone. Today I going to update my sugar apple, or you can call the sweet shop. This one is rain lily, and this one is tamarind. We use it fruit to make the sour soup. My rain lily just start blooming. The best bloom is the end of July and August when they have a lot of rain, especially the hurricane season. And this the sugar apple that I'm talking about. This one here is little over 3 years old already. It's about 3 years old. This one I had 2 trees next to each other, and then when you plant 2 trees one next to the other, it's not good because I had no room to grow. One is over here, but I just remove, put in the pot, because when it's small it's okay, but when it's grow bigger, it's too crowded and there's no fruit good. They don't produce a lot of fruit because I just moved 1 tree out and it disturbed the root. The flower here, they call a blue butterfly flower. You can use the flower to make tea, and they have a lot of benefit, more than 10 different benefits to the body. And this one here, this tree here, over 3 years old too, but this almost 4 years old, let's say a 4 year old tree. All the trees are growing from seed. It takes less than 2 years for sugar apple to start fruiting. They 4 years old already, that's why they have a lot of fruit. I don't use too much fertilizer. I do use little bit fertilizer too. I got from Lowe's or Home Depot. And my area, when my sugar apple start setting fruit, they had start having a flower, it's no rain. That's why the fruit is small. If it have a lot of rain, will be big like this. This one about 3/4 pound. No, not 3/4 pound, more than 1/2 pound. And 2 fruit this big, it made more than 1 pound. About 3 fruit is 2 pound. This one is the good size. And this one almost 4 years old too. You can say 4 years old. They do have a lot of fruit too. They have at the bottom too, but I don't take the picture at the bottom. And this sugar apple, oh no, sorry, this the sugar cane. This they call Hawaiian got that pele smoke sugar cane, because this is a rare sugarcane because they have purple leaf. When they start having leaf, they have a purple color. And then they change to dark green. I heard the people, they say they had a benefit for the diabetes, the people had diabetes. I'm not sure because I research on the Google, they don't say anything. This area here, see this tree, this one I grow, I plant two tree too. That's why, see this tree here, off the center of my square thing. Because when it's small, I thought, maybe I put two tree, it produce more fruit and take less space, but it's not true. It's not necessary for you to plant two tree, one next to the other, because all the tree, they need space to grow. That's why you can see this very bushy, and this side here, not much branch, or it's not bushy, because I just remove one tree out. The tree I just move out from here, this tree here. When I move it, I move this about sometime in February or March. It's like 4 or 5 months already. It interrupts the root. When they disturbing the root, they stretch about 1 or 2 months, and then it go back to normal. That the reason why they don't suck a lot of fruit, because I just remove it from this spot, just like what I say. This one about 4 years old too, but it's not grow very good because I just moved out from here. Here they have, yeah, that normal fruit. It's about maybe 20 or 30 fruit in this tree, because this tree 4 years old. And this tree, see this side, no branch on this side, because this the one I just moved from here. And this area here in the branch too. That the reason do not plant two tree, one next to the other. And this one here, I just move it away from the first tree. That's what I told you, I move one out and then I put it in the pot. They do only one fruit, because after I move it, especially when you put it in the pot, it's stress. The tree is stress, that's why I only one fruit. This is about 3 years old too, over 3 years old. It's supposed to set a lot of fruit, but because I move it, put it in the pot, that's the reason it don't have much fruit. And this one 4 years old, it's doing okay. Okay, that's, I show you one more tree. You can grow sugar apple in the pot too. I grow in this part here is about 15 gallon or 20 gallon, I'm not sure. Between 15 and 20 gallon. I had the people to comment why I don't air late, why I prefer to grow from seed. The reason I prefer to grow from seed because the one grow from seed is stronger than the one early. Because you grow from seed, they had the main root. It survive cold weather better than the one you early. I'm live in zone 10. Zone 10 very close to the zone 11. And at night time in the winter, sometime temperature they go out, go down to 38 degrees Fahrenheit. It's about 18 degrees Celsius, 18 degrees C. But it lasts only one night or two nights. And the leaves, they do fall off. They burn out, the cold burn out the leaf and fall off. But in spring, they grow back. And the one I air laid, it killed completely. Then the reason why I prefer to grow from seed. I grow one in the pot because I think if the temperature go down to the freezing point, I will move it into my garage. But I never had chance to move it into my garage because they never go down below 35 degrees Fahrenheit in my area. They do one time in the winter 2017-18, they do go down to 30 degrees Fahrenheit, and the wind chill, they go down to 20 degrees, and they hang in there about a week, like 7 days to 10 days. That's the reason all my sugar apple, they all die. But they not burn all the way to the root. And springtime, they all come back. Okay, thank you for you all for watching my video. One more thing, I'm just the home grower, just grow my fruit tree for fun. I'm not the commercial guy. So I don't know much about the fruit tree or about the farm. Whatever I know, I just tell you guys like that. Okay, thank you for watching my video. If you like, you can like, subscribe. Thank you, goodbye.